All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the DreamHack Stockholm Counter-Strike Global Offensive Tournament. We are about to get into Group B now, having seen two French teams make it through Group A. One of the teams in the intro video is out, Anders.
There's something highly sort of anticlimactic about the idea that NIP, in spite of all that posing, not making it through. It's a real shame.
But maybe now, as you were saying, it's time to pursue a career in boy bands and being a boy band.
They're very pretty people on the NIP team, definitely.
Yeah, but Fnatic are still here, and we're about to see Fnatic play. And Crims, it's time to put that game face on. The one you had in the video, you better be like that at Inferno right now.
When we get to Globe, and I'm going to ask Crims if he can help me look that tough, because it's really, there must be like an art to it. Looks, it's impressive. It really is.
Flusher is just a big teddy bear, though. Like, he's one of those guys who just looks like I'm going to mess you up. But
you kind of
want to
give Flusher a
hug.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. Give Flusher a hug if you see him. He looks like he's ready for it. Yeah, but they're going to be playing 3D Max, the Finns that have come all this way. Pretty cool. And it's going to be on cash for a best of one here. The first game of the second group.
Yep, exactly right. So we're going to be getting into it on cash as well.
Yeah, because apparently all the Danes are missing.
Well, apparently we're missing two of the Danes. And the funny thing is that it's like one from each team as well. So what I proposed is that we actually just play it out 4v4.
Yeah, it's not a bad idea.
See how that goes.
Those Danish people, just can't trust them, can you?
No, apparently not. Apparently you can't trust airplanes either to show up on time. Because apparently that's what happened with Pimp, is that his flight got delayed by 2 hours or something. So.
And the metro stopped. Maybe it's just like a general transportation breakdown today.
Well, it's not the best timing considering, you know, they were in the second group of the day to boot. You know, give them a bit more time to get here, and now we don't have two Danes. Well, I mean, there's plenty of Danes in Sweden. I'm sure we can just grab two more, right?
No, I can stand in for them if they really need me. It's not that far away. I'd do it. I've been playing with Dignitas.
5 minutes on the metro and you're there.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I've been playing with Dignitas. I've been playing with Kerrigan a while too, so yeah.
I'm ready.
Yeah, just call me up.
I haven't played at all with Kerrigan. Played a lot with AC.
Try not to play with Kerrigan, because what happens when you play with Kerrigan is when it gets past 10 o'clock in the evening, he gets a little bit tired and, you know, he stops taking things seriously. And what he does, this is, I'm not joking, what they do is they buy the auto sniper. And they aim into the ground, and in their minds, it looks like a vacuum cleaner. So they start making vacuuming noises, and they run around the map doing that, and you lose, no matter what happens. It's very frustrating, in fact. All right, well, this is the Finnish team. And they, I would say, are definitely the underdogs going into this one, but they have a lot of experience, and it being a best-of-one game, and it being on cash as well, makes me say there's still a chance here. Now, too, at the second-to-last down at the end there, very recognizable and a very, very cool guy. Has years of experience. Probably the most out of anyone in the scene right now. Natu has more sort of time played, if you take his whole career. And he just happens to be an amazing guy as well. Very friendly, very cool. And yeah, just a great person.
Yeah, all around. No doubt about it. So it's really cool to see that 3D Max are here with the new organization as well, because these guys were Encore before, and now being picked up by 3D Max is 3D Max's venture back into CS, and they chose a good team to go with, because the Finnish team, not to incorporate basically, it's going to be really good. And they're going up against Fnatic, that's the thing though. They're going up against Fnatic, Crims, Olafmeister, Flusha, the guys that we saw in this video right now, but also the team that has been playing the best since Gamescom, pretty much. Online, they had an undefeated streak of like 15 maps until they managed to stop them.
I've got to think maybe Fnatic are feeling a bit disappointed going into this, because they came here to get revenge on NIP, and they don't even get to do it. NIP are out before they even get to Globen. So I don't know. Maybe Fnatic are feeling great. They're feeling all right. The rest is just smooth sailing, which would be a big mistake to think. But you know, at the same time, I bet Fnatic would like revenge, because they were this damn close to beating them in Cologne.
Well, what's going to happen here? If Fnatic were to take first seed, basically it should be LDLC against the second seed of this group. Fnatic will play against Titan if they take first seed here. So you'll have Fnatic Titan in the in one of the matches, one of the semis that would happen tomorrow. So basically, for a French rematch, Titan have to beat Fnatic.
Yeah.
In the grand finals.
I think that's how it works out.
And then LDLC would have to beat either Dignitas, Copenhagen Wolves, or 3D Max.
I'm very upset that Crims is all the way down at the bottom. I wish we could get a shot of that face, just because he still looks fierce. I can tell all the way from down here that he's pumped up.
Yeah.
With the rest of Fnatic looking pretty normal here. Pronex in the middle, of course, the caller. And
And Devil Walk behind them. I mean, Devil Walk the coach.
Where's Khan?
Khan is in Singapore right now. He's actually a traitor, because he's with the LoL team.
Oh, well, all right.
Sorry. Well, I mean, it is the world. It's like the world championship for League of Legends right now. So, I mean...
Fair enough thing. He gets this one off, though. I guess that's all right.
And basically, that's like his place, too. He wants to be in Singapore. He loves it, Singapore. Singapore. Random Karn factoids. All right, but getting into it, Devilwalk is here. He's still the coach. He's still got the team's back. And since this change, since the ex-LGB members, Olafmeister and Crims, have been picked up for Fnatic, they've performed consistently better. And that's also with Devilwalk there, coaching them, making sure that, you know, they fix the little mistakes, but also gathering in all that information on their opponents and making sure that Pronax is constantly up to date on what's happening and with the with his opposition.
So... I mean, I'm always looking forward to seeing Fnatic play. They're a really fun team to watch. But on LAN here today, and actually for this whole tournament, the one guy I just want to watch is JW, because he has been playing so well online recently.
And
if he could just go into this LAN and do this, it would be crazy.
I would be sick if he can pull off the kind of plays that he's been doing online. And that's why we've renamed him the J Whirlwind.
The J Whirlwind.
Because seriously, he rolls around with an AWP and a CZ75 and murders entire teams.
Yeah. Yeah, because JW's actually short for Jesper WoW, which is, I guess, the Whirlwind could be.
Oh, he's the J Whirlwind as far as I'm concerned. Basically, you know, 3D Max, they're going to have to, it's like, you know, when you're in tornado territory, right? You got to go and find a bathtub or something or a bunker to sit in or just tie a belt around yourself to a piece of pipe or something like that, right? That's what's going to happen with 3D Max right now. They're going to be strapping each other down, trying to hold on for dear life because JW is about to roll through them.
Yeah, I think that's about accurate. Mm-hmm. I mean, that AWP CZ75 combo is really ridiculously strong on him. It actually has to be just a matter of time before more AWPers start to use it as actively as he does.
Well, look at Kenny.
Yeah, that's but I mean, even more. And JW clearly does it way more. So, it's a growing trend, no doubt.
That's the beauty of the JW like situation, is that he will just go Mag 7, CZ75 or AWP CZ75 and just destroy it, because now it's not even a question of him having to land the shots. He's got a little submachine gun in his pocket. He's got the AWP, and the funny thing is that he actually uses the CZ more than he does the AWP. In these close situations, he'll run up to people, CZ them in the face, and then use the AWP to finish off the last guy. And you're like, how is that? Like, isn't it supposed to be the other way around? Like, the CZ is supposed to be your backup weapon, and JW's like, nah.
Well, that's how, traditionally, if you do get close to an AWPer and he misses the shot, that's when you have, like, this feeling that, yes, I did it. You know, now I can just, like, hold down -1, and I'll kill him before he even gets a chance to reload. But with JW, it doesn't always work out that way.
No, he's not interested in that. He breaks the norm, Sanders. He sets the trends.
Yeah, that's what it is. JW. Say hello to my little friend. That's that kind of action.
I'm just really excited to see the JW play, Pronax with the calls, because now we're on LAN, and Pronax is one of the shiftiest characters in CS. He's one of the best in-game leaders, but he always has those sneaky snake-in-the-grass plans, always able to catch people off guard. So 3D Max, as we see here on our screen, they're gonna have to be really on their toes right now. They have to be aware of everything that Fnatic can throw at them, but I'm positive that we're going to see new plays come out here from Fnatic.
And I mean, they were recently picked up this finish lineup by the 3D Max organization, who made their way back into Counter-Strike after being out a little bit. Mm-hmm. So I'm guessing they also have something worth fighting for with 3D Max, just wanting to show the absolute best that they can and impress everyone. So I think it's cool. I'm glad that 3D Max decided to pick up this particular team, actually.
Yeah, absolutely. And this, I mean, so much experience on this team, but also solid play online. So we're really going to have to see if they're going to be able to step it up here on LAN. The last time that this team played on LAN was Aces ROG. Mm. They got into the finals after taking out Nostalgia, and that was the team that had Kaylee and Apex on, you know, Overdrive's team, right? And they took them out in the semifinals, but then lost to the Danish team My Revenge in the finals.
Yeah.
So that was the last performance for Encore at the time. Now it's 3D Max. Mm. We're going to have to see if they're going to be able to show a little bit more consistency here on that in this group phase.
I'm still waiting for the advent of InFaculty at one point or another. They're surely going to come back.
They're going to come back.
Do some stuff. So a couple of decent Danish teams they could pick up right now if they wanted to.
Sure. Sure. I mean, well... Who is it that I'm thinking about right now? Because, well, you have my XMG already, and they're kind of like the third team on the tier right now in Denmark. Then you have Nosir. Yeah, Nosir could be a really good pickup for them.
Yeah,
Nosir qualified for Fragbite. So,
exactly. So now that would be a really good time. Just think about it. Well, we're just waiting still. I mean, everyone's at their seat, so it can't be that much longer. But thank you all for tuning in so far here to the DreamHack Stockholm stream. Of course, we have another couple of games coming up for you here this evening. It's far from... Actually, we're only halfway through. So you're right on time. And then tomorrow, Semler and I are going to be headed over to Globin, but we'll be joined by Thorin, the one and only. And that's going to be great. Been way too long since we've been hanging out with Thorin, and it's going to be really enjoyable. So we're looking forward to that a lot.
And hopefully you all will be there too, because you can still buy tickets. Tickets are still open for the event. And if you're here just to watch CS, you can get a one-day pass. And, I mean, it's going to be CS on the main stage in Globin Arena. That's a pretty sick event to be a part of. So if you're around in the Stockholm area and you can get some time off work, perhaps, definitely come on by and say hi.
Yeah, and, you know, come and say hi to us as well if you feel like it. Mm-hmm. I always get texts from people afterwards, after an event, someone always tweeting me and telling me, I saw you, but I didn't want to say hi. I was like, do it. Don't be afraid. Say hi. It's
say
worth
hi.
It. It's always, always more fun meeting people in real life.
It's more of a nibble.
Never mind. Not gonna go into that right here. Don't wanna risk it all.
Kind of curious as to what the delay is right now. Seeing as how the map is selected, we should probably be going through the knife right now to see who's gonna be starting on which side.
Yeah, I would think so.
But I don't think it's gonna matter too much. I think a lot of this is gonna come down to whether 3DMax can actually start on that CT side, get a bit of a head start. But Fnatic are going to be perfectly comfortable on whichever side. You know, offense, defense. I think they're pretty well rounded right now on all of the maps, nearly.
Yeah, I think so. Cash, probably not Fnatic's strongest map, but I think they're going to be strong enough on it that it won't make that big a difference. Mm-hmm. There are key rounds that could be won by 3DMax that could really swing. I mean, the pistol round, sure, but if they start really knocking down Fnatic in the few rounds when Fnatic can start to buy, that's where it makes a big difference. And they have some players that could do it. Like you mentioned Disturb earlier. Karan, I think, is actually a really stable player. He's been playing sort of at a pretty stable level for a long time.
Yeah.
For me, one of the guys to really watch is Stilixart. I think he's been upgrading his level quite a bit recently, in my opinion. So, yeah, I think he's my guy to watch. And he actually does sometimes pick up Oping as well and stuff like that on the team. So, yeah, we'll see. We'll see.
No, he's kind of... I think he's their go-to opper, at least.
Yeah.
Because I don't think anybody else on that team is really picking it up. Maybe Disturbed goes with this with like the auto sometimes, but Natu, Rifler right there. The rest of them definitely Riflers. So we'll see if they're going to be able to bust out the AWP here. I'm wondering if 3DMax are going to rather than take on JW in an op battle, if they're going to want to try and favor Rifles and just be quick on their feet and keep the pressure up like that.
Could be.
Maybe if they can find entries, basically. Like the game plan has got to be revolving around entry frags for them. If they can find entries and just speed up behind that, perhaps they can catch Fnatic off guard that way.
I wouldn't be surprised if they try and go for quite a lot of aggression on the CT side, because they're Finnish as well. That's like crazy people. They make it work. So, I mean, just look at them. They look fearless as well.
Yeah, they look like they're having a good time. Natu is just, you know...
I challenged Natu for that ice bucket challenge thing that was going on,
and he did it,
and a bunch of people were telling me afterwards, you realize that's not even a challenge for a Finnish person. They dip themselves in ice and they go in the sauna and just relax. So I thought about that too late. It's pretty true.
Halfway there, especially because Natu's got this sick hot tub as well. So he probably just like he pulled a nothing, and he's just like, okay, there it is. Okay, it's cold, great, hop in the hot tub.
Exactly, just relaxing. So maybe not that.
Yeah,
maybe
Natu is sick too, because sometimes when there's tournaments when they aren't playing, right, he'll bring his TV outside and just sit in the hot tub and watch the CS on his TV.
Yeah, good stuff.
He's definitely one of the cooler cats in the scene, no doubt about it.
Yeah, definitely. So if you guys are looking for something to spend the time on while you're waiting, then you can go and visit Senra and I's website at roomonfire.tv if you want to. Check it out. Go click around. Fun links to be found. Also, some hints on the side about what we're doing in the future. But that's a good place to keep eye on us. And there are links to our social medias and stuff like that. If you want to help us out, then follow them right there. Apart from that, though...
if you want to see the sexiest skin in Counter-Strike as well.
That's true. Semler not being biased at all, but it is a really good skin.
It is.
Yeah. All right, there it is.
The sexiest skin. Go find out what it is. Roomonfire.tv.
I'm still surprised by the fact that we've seen Cash twice today in a best of one format. I know it's the new map pool. I know that we have Overpass and Cobblestone with us here, but it used to be for a long time that it was just Inferno and Dust 2, and mainly Inferno, right? It was the Counter-Strike Inferno offensive for a while.
Well, I still feel like Cobble is a map that people are avoiding right now, that teams aren't really... wanting to put too much into it, because they're still going to get a ban, right? It feels like a lot of these teams are much more comfortable on Overpass. And despite the changes made to Cobblestone, I would really love to see teams play on Cobblestone just to see if some of that new mid connector actually works out. Because they did add a connector that allows for a fast rotation from the T side over to between A and B in there. So I was curious, is that going to be something that comes into play? They made a couple more changes around the sites as well. It'd be really interesting to see the players, try and get an actual official match in to really, you know, see them playing seriously on it to develop that map, because it isn't, I don't think it's going anywhere, at least not in the near future. So what's happening?
Well,
why are they not playing it?
I mean, in fairness to Valve, if we claim, and I do claim that it's going to take like 6 months for any team to really fully be capable of playing some of the new maps, then at the same time, it doesn't really make sense to remove a map within that time, unless you have like a really good substitute for it, because it's also going to take that long before you start to really get an idea about balancing the map anyway. So, well, we do see everyone's on the server as far as I can tell. We're just waiting. We're waiting for the get-go.
I can't be sure. Maybe... No, I see five people for 3D Max. Do I see five people for Fnatic? The questions, Anders, the questions.
Yeah.
Apparently one of them has microphone problems. That's why we have the delay here. So you kind of do need to be able to speak to your teammates. It's kind of an important part of the game, communication.
Yes, it definitely is a lot easier if you try and do that. For it'll be out there playing matchmaking. Get a microphone.
Unless you're Kenny or Kaylee. Talking isn't really necessary when you can frag half the team.
Well, especially not if you're playing on the Nostalgia team. I can't remember. I think it was actually Vendetta was telling me about how they were. Because one of the time, I think either Apex or Kenny was streaming.
Yeah.
When they were playing with the Nostalgia team. And the communication is hilarious because they just like they all speak very broken English and they don't really say Apex, a lot, but when they do, it's really funny.
It's like Kaylee, but that was really fun at ASUS RG because that's where they were, and Kaylee and Ken. Yeah, it's like Kaylee speaks English; she can understand sort of, but it's just very, very stereotypical French, like yes, good or whatever, you know. And you're just like, okay, you know. But Apex is the guy who's actually trying to run the show because he actually sort of speaks English. Overdrive is maybe more like one word delivery, right? You know, just like, oh, pit, you know.
A little bit. I mean, we actually, the first time I went to Overdrive was at the
Well, you were at Prog Challenge with Thorin, yeah.
With Thorin, yeah. And we did interview him a little bit because there was a rumor going around that he had basically bought this team because his father is a millionaire and he had like the money. That was like very strange, okay. Which he denied. That wasn't apparently. Apparently, he just works like a regular job and he makes the money. And then instead of going to Ibiza or somewhere else for a vacation, he finds a Counter-Strike team and goes to an event, have some fun with it, which is still a fun idea.
It's cool.
That rumor kind of is still persistent, but I don't know. That's the first time I met Overdrive anyway, and his English was all right. You can talk to him.
Yeah, no, Overdrive is really, really a nice guy, actually. It was great to meet him at ASUS. He's a very cool guy. We ended up getting into like a political discussion as well. It was very weird.
That's dangerous.
Yeah, dangerous, right? But you know, we navigated it. We weren't at each other's throats, so it was actually quite cool. But right now, guys, we're still waiting to see if that mic problem is going to get fixed. You know,
yes.
So it's always a bit silly because it always seems like
mic check 1-2. I think Fnatic are on the CT side now. Yeah. So they hopefully that means we're going to be ready soon. They've done the knife already, and should be just a matter of seconds before we get into it. Fnatic team looking warmed up and pretty relaxed as well. Nothing too exciting.
Well, they can't get too relaxed because we can't forget that they're the Swedish Hope now. And on home turf, NiP are now out of the tournament. It's going to be Fnatic here. So
it would be truly disastrous if Fnatic also didn't make it to Globen tomorrow. I can't even imagine the consequences. Well, Fnatic have a three-man stack, all of them in checkered over there. That is... Actually, I've never seen that piece around before from anyone. That's interesting.
It's definitely a very cool play. If they come rushing in here, sometimes you do have teams that decide to go for very...
Oh my god.
Are you kidding? This could be perfect. Olafmeister is forced out of the corner. Crims is still waiting though.
Reflex. If that had been 2 pixels further to the right, it is already a really cool play, but if it had been a little bit more to the right, that would have been the sickest start. Very nicely done. So here we are. Beginning of it. This is DreamHack Stockholm best of one between Fnatic and 3D Max. Welcome to the show, everyone. Let's see if the Finnish Hope can somehow manage to upset the situation here. Fnatic clearly the favorite team, but you never know in a best of one. The beginning here is going to mean a lot. And actually, right now, Pronax is the only one holding. This is a great read by the Finnish team. Pronax is going to put up a Molotov, but that's not going to block the whole site. It may sort of block the standard part, but they should be able to put down the bomb here anyway pretty quickly.
That is blocking the standard plant, and already Pronax manages to pick up one headshot. Reflex is dropped, or Exart rather, is dropped fairly low here as well for 3D Max, but they're just going to be closing in. And Fnatic, with this man advantage, can apply the chokehold. they can just close in on 3D Max, get them boxed in on this site, and rush them down. And that's exactly what's happening here. Flusha taking point, but XR Natu with two. And this Natu killing one of his own teammates. That doesn't help.
No, it doesn't disturb here at the back of site. Has to stay alive. Just wait it out. He's going to try and go for JW. Gets the time to reload, and there it is. Instantly turns around, and they have the kit as well. So they are going to be able to get that defuse in. Oh, great retake from Fnatic. 3D Max, they almost managed to break it home. And there's one, there was one feature actually of this round that annoyed me a little bit. So I don't know if you noticed, but in the main entrance in towards that A bomb site, Caron was actually waiting there. And he was waiting in that position because he was worried that someone from Fnatic was backstabbing. Mm-hmm. But no one ever did. And I kind of wish he would have rotated all around through middle. I wish he would have tried to backstab Fnatic from that position. Because initially he would have had the time to do it. But I guess that's kind of a hard call for him to make exactly right then. But it looked like there was a slight opening for some trickery right there.
Let's figure it out exactly what is going to happen here. Pronax again holding on this A site. Solo for now. He's going to have support from Short, however. Double crossfire. In fact, Olafmeister's already lighting people up left and right. And this is looking like another Fnatic anti-eco round. Near perfection. Olafmeister gets overwhelmed at the end. Before remaining members here for Fnatic, it's still a solid round. Oh, JW actually not wasting any time. He goes straight for the AWP.
Yeah, so not playing like some of the other teams we've been seeing earlier that prefer to have just one guy running around with a pistol.
CZ, yeah.
Another team that does that a lot is Copenhagen Wolves, Nico, playing a lot with Glock when he's on the terrorist side until he can pick up an AWP. But yeah, JW going straight for it.
Not wasting any time at all. I suppose that's no big surprise considering it's JW, but JW also, I mean, we have seen Fnatic in the past also go for full rifles, much like Titan, so... It looks like right now they're going to be allowing the Swedish offer to go to work. And this is going to be actually a pretty decent situation for him, seeing as how the smoke does go down, but he is alive on this site. And if he were to just take a shot there, he could start off strong.
Yeah, he's Molotov out of the back, but he's still going to be picking up a kill here. He misses the next one, and then almost a double to return. He's going to go down, and this is looking great for the Finns. It's Flusha and Crims left. The bomb is going to be planted, and they can get into good positions. Again, this time you see Exod in that position. And he could actually be wrapping around to backstab the remaining Fnatic members. Right now, he's just checking to see if anyone's coming. But if they don't come in a couple of seconds, why not just move? Caron, now 1-on-3 here for Flusha.
This is actually fantastic. Flusha turns away, and there you go.
Sick round.
Bit of life there in 3D Max as well. They're going to be feeling good about picking up their first buy round, third round. And now, I don't think there's going to be enough money for a full buy here from Fnatic.
No, there probably won't be, but they might force it up anyway. The really wonderful thing about this round was how well 3D Max managed to use these smoke grenades to directly counter that AWP from JW. So it may have been a little bit early, but apparently 3D Max were ready for it.
They just smoked everything up there. A couple missed shots there from JW as well that would have really turned the tide. It's going to be... 3D Max just getting boosted up here. Nice little pressure in mid. Gonna open up this map, basically give them some options as to where they want to go on this site.
Disturbed. Smoking off. It's a good idea. Just taking it slowly here. Not really risking too much. Pronax again. The 5-7 in hand is gonna be forced back, and Disturbed will take him down. So things are looking quite good right now for the Terrier side.
Fnatic. At this point, their aim is to try and get into position to get some exit frags, but the smokes are just keep landing in mid-connector. 3D Max wanting to make sure that they aren't able to get backstabbed, really. So they're going to funnel Fnatic into the common spots. CT spawn, for example, and Caron is already looking. Would like to see Caron take a bit more of a passive position, however, and not exactly face. He's only got 18 HP, and that's well within lethal range here for these CZs.
Yeah, it's going to be Natsu's turn to walk in, and JW's waiting there. Does a lot of damage here to the 3D Max leader, but can they make it out alive? Fnatic do have a really good shot at getting a lot of exit kills, which would be kind of bad for the Finnish side.
Yeah, you need three of these members from 3D Max to get pretty far away as well, so to avoid this bomb blast, Crims could lay into them, but Reflex leads the way, soaks up the damage, and manages to get the kill. And it's going to be JW alone in Garage, nobody here for him to go ahead and frag. He's got his CZ-75, though, but only 34-50 on him. This is still enough to force up on Fnatic's side.
It is enough to force up, but it won't be enough for them to buy an AWP, say. I still would be surprised if they're not going to go for the buy, just because I think Fnatic... are coming into this game feeling very, very confident. I think they feel like, all right, let's just get run over 3D Max and then get into playing Dignitas House or Copenhagen Wolves and see how that goes, which is not a good mentality to get in with, actually. They need to think about this game before anything else, because that would give the terrorist side right now a big opening. Absolutely. Fnatic underestimating them would be the best thing they could do.
There's some of the best finished talent on this team right here, yeah. So you can't really exactly take 3D Max lightly. And this buy isn't actually that big of a deal because they still got four M4s. All of them rocking the silencer as well, so that's interesting that Fnatic, they choose Unity rather than having a mix of A4 and A1. And JW still has that CZ75 to complement the scout, so there's still quite a bit of firepower here for Fnatic. 3D Max have to be a little bit careful as to how they approach this, although 3D Max still have all of their smokes and all of their mollies. If they were to go for an A play, they could basically choose where they want to go at this point and just completely bombard a site into oblivion.
Yeah. Actually, I definitely think it's very reasonable for Fnatic to go for all these silence weapons because there's so many places on this map where you can get shot at from multiple angles, and it can be really hard to know exactly where you're getting shot from. Even in the speed bomb side, you know, upper or lower, exactly where the shot's coming from could be a little bit more difficult with that silence weapon. Now they're going to smoke off, and counter flashes are coming out as well from the Fnatic side. Just 20 seconds left here for the terrorist side to make it through, and it's not looking easy, but Xart Disturbed picking up two great return frags now. It's only Flusher in here, picks up one, goes for a second one. He still has five bullets left, going to peek again, and Xart down there looking for the kill. We'll pick up the double, 8 seconds, 7 seconds, and now there's no more times. Caron can't really do anything. He picks up the one kill, but he will lose this round, and that is a real shame. That very nearly worked. If they'd realized instantly where Flusher was, and again, they couldn't. The silenced weapon makes it so much more difficult. But if they had, that could have been an opening.
But also having so much defense on Fnatic here, already on this B site, it's going to be Flusher here, as we see the replay. Him buying so much time as well to allow for Olafmeister to come through that smoke on upper and line up the shot. So good play there by Fnatic, but that was still a very expensive round from them. 3D Max still have ample money to go for a rebuy in this round. So the pressure is not going to let up here for the Swedes. The Finns definitely looking to take advantage here. But Disturbed is going to manage to spot out JW at mid-sandbags, and that's going to be some pressure going out. He's deciding to have a bit of a flambe that could force JW to change up his position. But for now, at least, 3D Max, they're actually in a great position to just take over A-site, and Olafmeister gets caught out in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, nice opening from Reflex. Could they do a little bit more? Olafmeister already gone, and they have a one-man advantage. JW is also very low on health here. And in spite of having the advantage, you can see the Finnish team actually aren't rushing it. They're still playing very carefully, and that's a great sign. It's a very healthy sign for a team in this position.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and really not taking too many risks. They've still got plenty of nades. Down to one flash, though, but still, this is going to force Fnatic into a bit of an awkward position. They're going to walk into a bunch of different crossfires. It's going to be Crims taking point. He manages to overwhelm Natu immediately, however. So strong play there. Finds Reflex, and this is now down to the last man here for 3D Max. All on Caron in a 1v2. He just needs to stay alive at this point, but Crims assassinates him, and this is going to be Fnatic bouncing right back into the driver's seat. Four rounds now for them.
That was a very important, very impressive round from Crims, of course. And I'm wondering if the communication was lacking just a little bit here on the 3D Max side. It seemed like, actually, in this particular position, when Crims goes back around, I guess Reflex, yeah, he thought there was someone in there, but it was actually his teammates. I'm wondering if he got a little bit tricked.
A little turned around there.
Yeah. That's a shame, because that was a really good position overall for 3D Max. But 4-2, Fnatic looking predictably quite strong, and JW still, even with the scout, he's still being very annoying in the middle.
Oh, that molly just barely gets down. That's going to work out perfectly here for Team 3D Max. It's going to force JW into a bit of a tight spot, or a hot spot. That did not work.
He was so hungry to get the kills, he actually was just walking around the fire there. Natu can't pick up that kill on Pronax, and in the middle, Sai goes down. So we're looking at a flawless round here from 3D Max, and now they're starting to get in there.
Yeah, now it seems like Fnatic are starting to pick up momentum.
Yeah.
Keeping so many members alive now means that they get to have plenty of money to invest in these rounds, and they could potentially upgrade JW to that AWP, which is, I think, going to be the go-to strategy for him there. Just get him that AWP, let him start shutting people down, but so long as he doesn't die, he's content to hold on to the scout. And in this sort of situation, 3D Max ecoing, the scout is great. One shot, one kill with no Kevlar, so he's going to be able to just use it like an AWP, and he's going to be even more mobile. So this is a great weapon here for JW, who just loves to run around the map.
It absolutely is. Olafmeister is defending me. He's got two people right next to him, so when that squeaky door opens, the backup should be there pretty quickly.
Smoke goes out. Bit of an odd timing there, but Pronax is going to manage to whip out his gun in time and shut this down. It's going to be one man getting overwhelmed. Crims, they get revenge, but not before he gets two frags. Still, Fnatic, six rounds now, and they're still continuing to develop a sick bank. 3D Max in the meantime, after that round of eco, have plenty of money to invest in this round. Do they go for an AWP on Exart is what I'm wondering at this point. Do they want to count on him going toe-to-toe?
Yeah.
And yes, he will have that AWP. So JW has upgraded himself, and this is going to be the battle now.
Yeah, definitely really important if they can get him to get the opening frags. And actually, JW's all the way in the back, so there's going to be a bit of an op battle here. If he just moves up a little bit, they both miss the shot. And JW has some backup in the vents, Crim. So if they try and rush him down here, it's going to work out. And that's such a great duck. Just crouching in, and Sart, fast as he is, couldn't pick up that kill.
Incredible. Now this is JW in his element. And now with that pop flash as well. But Pronax is going to find Corona over on the A site. That squeak door cleaned up. Crims, not sure if they've found him in the vents yet, but this is a very tough position for 3D Max to find themselves in. They're two man down. They still have plenty of nades to work for, but they have to find an entry somewhere to create some space. And Fnatic are giving them zero opportunities at this point. Fnatic are very much in control of mid and just willing to hold on to the sites. It's going to be down to the clock, really. 3D Max are going to have their hand forced for them.
Yeah. They're still spending a lot of time in the middle, and Flusher's tired of waiting. He's going to go and find them instead, and this is definitely going to catch them off guard. That's the opening headshot here. Goes for a second one, almost picks up Reflex. And actually, Natu's going to pick up that kill on Crims. So that opens up a little bit of a room in towards that B-bomb side if they wanted to, but they're actually going back around, and all of Maestro's merciless.
Yeah, that's the important bit as well. For a second, Pronax was definitely exposed, looking the wrong way, but Natu, now that he's lost his bomb carry over in A main, he's pretty much... This is what happens. He has to go and try and find that bomb, but Pronax, of course, abuses that information and just shuts him down on short. So
I'd like to see 3D Max go for a B-split push through the vents, because you see actually right here. So JW's in checkered, and up in the vents, we saw that Crims was there. That duck is still beautiful, but if you force Crims, who's in the vents, to decide about defending middle or defending towards the checkered room, and then you flash all of Meister out, maybe, or JW, depending on who's there, you could be doing a good job. They're moving in pretty close. They're not splitting it. They're just running straight in here. And all of Meister's going to pick up the first kill, gets a second one, too. Peaks again, and he's going to miss it. Pistols out, and he's finally going to go down now. Two on two, and a pretty cool rush coming out in 3D Max that works really well.
Yeah, really solid. Pronax finds the angle, however, to pick up Reflex. It was in CT spawn, and this is going to be down to Natu. Now, 1v2 clutch situation for him. JW coming out on upper is going to force him out into the open. Pronax going for the mad spray, readjusts his aim. And gets the kill. This is the important bit. They even managed to save that AWP. They could actually have two of them now. Olafmeister's AWP and JW's. And that's exactly what's going to happen here. Fnatic going to count on these double sniper rifle plays. But Olafmeister certainly did his work right there. Getting those two frags, even doing the damage on the third. That's exactly what he has to do.
Now, close round here for the Finnish team, but it's not close enough. And especially that kill. Disturbed maybe could have been fast enough to take that one bound, but at the end, now to an uncomfortable situation. It's going to bring it into an 8-2 scoreline. A little bit of camera confusion. Flusher does pick up now to the beginning of this round. And the Finns just don't have that much money left. They need to start winning a little bit more. And look at how aggressive all of Meister is being over here.
Yeah, he's all the way out there. Look at this. Where do you go? And that's the bomb as well. Does he change up the angle to go and look towards Garage? He does, in fact. So he's got a very... this is a disgusting angle. I mean, they really are pacing themselves, but that smoke going down, that's really going to piss off 3D Max. Now all of a sudden they know that this is going to be even more time wasted because Exart now has to slow down his pace to try and clear this position. Olafmeister's bought a lot of time. They try to change up the angle, but Crims with the spray through the smoke manages to pick up a guy.
Very nicely done. Corona and Exart, I mean, they're only just now making it towards the B-bomb site. That is going to be an easy pickoff. Second kill, maybe, for Olafmeister here. They're just all peeking. And that's going to be it. 9-2. Fnatic are showing that their online performances translate very well into LAN play here. This is about the level that I think a lot of people were expecting from Fnatic.
Yeah, they still look incredibly good. Just clearly dominant right now. And this is going to be 9-2, yeah, for the Fnatic. They've got so much money. 3D Max forced to eco because they aren't getting plants. They aren't even really getting close to sites. Fnatic are just pushing out across the map at this point. JW, aggressive position in Squeak Door, manages to pick up Disturbed, who is carrying the bomb for 3D Max. So that's going to force another rotation. Two guys now for 3D Max in the Squeak Door area, but Fnatic are converging on this A site already. They know that this is where 3D Max are going to try and rush in.
Yeah, with just pistols, it's just complete slaughter. Nobody dying. Nobody even taking any damage on that side. 10-2. 13th round is coming up. Xart will pick up that AWP again. And his spawn is actually really far back in the bomb site, so he can't even run and try and challenge anyone at B really early, which is unfortunate. That would be a fun opening kill for them. If Fnatic, who they've been playing a lot in that vent, and there's another way to deal with the vent apart from just pushing it, is you can actually go back and Molotov it all the way over almost from sort of the outside of the A bomb site. So that could be another attempt, but right now you can see Fnatic aren't playing the vent, so it wouldn't even matter. They're going for a bit of an A push. We're just leaving one guy over at B, and that's Xart.
Yeah, Xart to try and draw some attention over there. He does have that AWP, so he could get into a battle with JW, who's holding on that side of the map. But there's still Olafmeister alive, looking down main. So if they come rushing in here, 3D Max are going to be greeted by his AWP. Seems like 3D Max want to go for a multi-boost into mid, basically. Two guys boosted up, and they're going to go together. So if Flusha picks up one, the other one for 3D Max is expected to get the frag.
Yeah, well, JW wins the battle over at B. Flashbang comes out here from Flusha by the sandbags, and it's going to be an easy kill for him on Natsu. Second headshot comes in. Disturbed is down, and Flusha will never surrender. And it's going to be a third one. Now Karon goes down in that bomb site, and that was a pretty solid mid defense there.
Flusha just doing, you know, just Flusha things.
Yeah, all he needed was like a Humvee to drive himself out of there.
He hops in the Hummer. He's like, oh, yo, I'm going to go get some food. I mean, dude. This is just such clean rifle work from him. The third one in particular just snaps too, adjusts his aim. And
yeah, be glad there's no Overwatch for this one.
Right?
It's ridiculous. All right, the fourth round, the 14th round is coming up here, and the vent is knife once again. There is a Molotov here on the 3D Max side, so maybe they could try and get rid of Flusha in this vent.
That's a nice flash, and well, he's going to spot a lot of guys out here for 3D Max. It's going to be Crims who's going to be the line here at the back, and that's not going to work for them. Fnatic getting overwhelmed somewhat. Flusha may have been able to find a shot, but it's going to be Olafmeister at the back of the site getting naded, and now he knows that somebody's out on this site with him. He is not alone. He's trying to check all the angles. Very awkward spot that he finds himself in here.
Yeah, but JW actually somehow manages to catch Natsu. Looked like he almost pre-fired at the edge of the smoke. I have no idea how that works. Reflex, though, has made his way into the B bomb site, which is really cool. If he's fast enough, maybe he can actually get in a better position here. If he gets up in the corner, no way are Fnatic going to try and check that. In fact, JW is in a bad position. He may get backstabbed here, and that's going to be the kill. Back into a 2-1-2. Let's see if 3D Max can end up an 11-4 if they could just win this round here. But Flusha gets the kill. Ixart now trapped inside the bomb site in the 1-on-2.
Yeah, Galil in hand. No nades to buy time with either. And it's going to be Olafmeister and Flusha to just close in on him like sharks. Flusha already trying to close the distance. Olafmeister setting it up with nades. They're just trying to do a little bit of preliminary damage here to 3D Max or to Xart, but it's a one-on-one situation. And Flusha's still alive here. Xart playing this beautifully, though. He's playing for the bomb. He's just playing a hide-and-seek game. So long as he stays alive behind these boxes, Flusha can't really do anything about this. And he just manages to pick up Flusha when he has to commit. So really well done there by Xart at the end, turning that two-on-two situation into a win.
Yeah, and hiding right next to the fire, I think, maybe tricked Flusha into thinking he probably wasn't going to be in that corner. So very intelligent play, definitely. And that's going to make it 11-3. Still a long ways to go for 3D Max right here, but yeah, they do have some talent.
Well, it's the 15th round, and they did manage to pick up that win, and that was crucial for them. It means they're going to have nades and rifles to work with here. They're going for the double boost again in mid. Flash over. Flusha gets annihilated, and this is not looking good. Pronax does manage to get in here, but no kills go Fnatic's way. It's a 2-on-5, and the only guys alive are actually JW and Olafmeister, and they're kind of closing in, playing aggressive at this point.
And what Fnatic were trying to do was actually doing a counter boost on the CT side, because you can do that. They just got caught mid-boost, and this is turning into a flawless round for 3D Max. It's sad that it's the 15th round, so they can't use this victory in upcoming rounds because they're going to be switching halves, but it's still a really impressive round for them.
I really like that pop flash that comes out as well. Like, really, that's definitely a play that 3D Max have put some time into to perfect, because they've got both guys boosted up, and then as soon as that flash goes off, they're through, they're pushing, and Fnatic this time around just get overwhelmed. So 3D Max now in a 1-on-4 plant position situation. JW is going to go leaping over it. Just catches Disturbed. But Natsu's in position to stop him from getting further into the site. And it's an 11-4 score hunt here in the first half. And this is very satisfactory for Fnatic. They're going to be pleased with this half.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Definitely something that they can use going into it. Win or lose the pistol round, they put themselves close to a victory already. There's really no denying it. So we're going to have to see 3D Max really convince us that that there's going to be like a comeback happening. Reflex, the top fragging for 3D Max right now, and actually very close to the top fragger on the Fnatic side, which is JW on 14. Mm-hmm. 14, 12, very close actually. That's cool.
That's the scary part when you look at it. It's basically nearly everybody on Fnatic are in double digits. Everybody on Fnatic in double digits right now. Yeah. And only Reflex above the 10 frag mark here for 3D Max. So this is the time for 3D Max to turn things around. Pistol round of the second half to decide who's going to get the guns. And this is going to be 3D Max slowing things down on this B site. But Fnatic have grouped up outside of it. So they're deciding to go for a YOLO play here, Fnatic. As soon as they spot something, flash in and this could be opening.
Yeah. Reflex potentially in a great position. This is a nice crossfire, but the Molotov won't save him. Krims will open it up. Disturbed looking for a return. He's not going to get it. That's double for Krims. And now Karon, is his turn to try and see if he can survive. They've made a swift rotation here on the CT side, but they're just not getting the kills right now.
Yeah, this is what it comes down to in the end. They're always facing two, three, four Fnatic members, and that's not going to help, especially in the pistol. Exart needs to land a brilliant headshot here, and he's looking towards Flusha, who's fairly low. Manages to find Pronax, and he's going to manage to pick him up, but are you kidding me? Flusha stops it from happening, but JW was looking for the knife at the end.
Yeah, he was. And a tiny detail that never really came into play at all, but something that Fnatic actually did that round is you saw at the end that they were boosting one guy up, counter-boosting in the vent. So if there had been an attempted reflex from 3D Max, that one guy was actually wrapping around through CT spawn. He would have been backstabbing him. There's no way you're going to read that as a CT team. That's so unlikely that that will happen. So, yeah, Fnatic sort of planning for the ultimate failure and making sure that they can maybe still come out of it on top.
Yeah, they always they go for this sort of thing on multiple maps as well.
Oh, oh.
The lob. That was graceful. That was graceful. Olaf Meister. He's basically the eye in the sky, the finger of God at this point. Three kills for him, and it will be another Fnatic round going into it.
Now let's see if the Finnish team has a little bit more to show us here. It's a really tough first opponent that they've managed to pit themselves against here in Fnatic. Probably in most people's minds, the favorites to take this whole thing. Even when IP was still in it, I think a lot of people would have said Fnatic anyway.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, it's going to be one more eco coming up, so basically 14-4 before 3D Max can realistically make a buy. And at that point, they've really got to make it work. Look at this, though.
That's cool.
Nice movement.
Yeah, nice one. Clever. Not 3D Max, however, they're striking back into this, managing to pick up one frag, but it's not going to be enough. It's a 4-on-4 situation, and Fnatic still have all of the guns. The question is, do they actually set up in the proper positions? The bomb is still back in Garage, so it's not shown. It hasn't been shown anywhere, and 3D Max are assuming it's going to be B. They have two guys on that site right now, and they've rotated one through CT spawn as well to lend a hand. And it will potentially be an B play here after all. But they're going out mid, so they may try and work their way up short or through vents and just try and split things up here on the B site. Yeah.
Yeah, and throwing a bit of a flashbang over towards A, pretending maybe they wanted to, you know, push up there. Yeah, you're right. It's going to be a B push. Good smoke off towards CT spawn. Karon, though, might not wait on the other side. He might just decide to push through as soon as anyone needs him.
Yeah, and there you go. He just goes lunging through, and there you go. Reflex, two big kills for him. Karon with the P250 can't connect, but Reflex is still alive on this site. Pronax finally gets rid of him, but it's a one-on-one. Exart with the P2K just goes YOLOing through the smoke again. Pronax, he has to know he's close.
Yeah, he tries, and oh, he picks up the headshot. That's a triple from Pronax. The fact is, Reflex was one kill away from having a pistol ace in that round. He's really playing well, Reflex. You gotta give it to him, but it's not enough right now.
No, it's certainly. It's now is when it really needs to step up here for our 3D Max. They've got the guns. Exart's got that AWP. They have decent number of nades. Now the battle. The B-side battle. There's the bait, and JW can't get the refrag.
No, but he peeks again. So yeah, they sacrifice Flusher, and then JW, the heavy artillery, gets into place and obviously makes it a whole lot more difficult. Karon down here, taking a little bit of fire in return, but he's doing some alright damage. And I think Fnatic have taken some grenade damage as well, so maybe there is something to be built off from here if you're on the CT side.
It's fairly even on both sides. Karon has dropped fairly low, however, so advantage Fnatic, especially since they've got that 4-on-4 situation on the T side. This will favor them when they decide to go for a plant. And Olafmeister picking off Disturbed, who is lurking pretty close to Garage there in mid. So this is going to open things up here for Fnatic. They've managed to get eyes on short. They're going to be able to smoke off connector. And yeah, Olafmeister now, they can start applying some pressure to this A side if they want to.
Yeah, but they're going to go for the same B push just like last time. Except they do leave Olafmeister over in the middle, so it's kind of even more annoying. JW is going to pick up Karon, and Reflex is smoked down, and actually, Olaf Meister does go down to Nato. He wins that battle, but is it enough for a retake? That's the question.
Yeah, it's a 2-on-4 situation at this point. Nato and Reflex, 2-on-4, 2-on-3 rather. But the bomb is going to get planted here, 25 seconds in the back corner as well. We saw how popular that plant position was for Titan.
Yeah, it worked really well. Definitely, dear. Reflex making some noise, just taking a step there, and Pronax for the final kill, so couldn't make the retake work. 15-4, straight into the 20th round, and obviously 3D Max going to be forcing up whatever they can. That's how it works.
And they have to. They have to try and stave off defeat. But it's looking like Fnatic have... It really does look like Fnatic have not been pressured at all in this match. They just look so clean. Their plays, their aim, everybody seems to be playing well right now. And as far as the calls are concerned, Pronax has been on point this entire time.
No. JW getting a taste of his own medicine with that Mag 7, but it's still a 4-on-3 here. And Olafmeister and Pronax and Flusher just... laying waste in the middle, leaving Nato alone, defending the A bomb site, which is not where the bomb is going, of course. Since they pretty much know that everyone else is dead, they can just go for it here.
Yeah, unfortunately. Nato not in the right place at the right time. And Olafmeister's already camping out in mid as well. He's going to be waiting, listening for where Natu's going to come from. Nato stomping his way through A main into Garage now, and Olafmeister should be able to hear this fairly soon. Unless Nato manages to pick up on the fact that somebody could be lurking out here.
Yeah, there you go. Definitely knows now. It's a good headshot coming in. But there is so little time left. He's not got a kit, so he has to actually just run the full distance and hope that he can just run in and take some insane headshots here. Otherwise, he's going to be out of time, simply.
Yeah, pop. Oh, the follow-up pop flash, so nasty. Nato doesn't turn away. He's going to face both of them at the same time, and Flusher will get the frag. So GG is called. Fnatic take a convincing first win here, and that puts them straight into the winner match of Group B. Did not look troubled, did not look pressured. They are looking like the team to beat at this tournament.
Yeah, right now at least the first group, first game of the second group here, and Fnatic looking about as strong as we were expecting. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not sure about the map choice. I feel like if we had been seeing 3D Max on Dust 2, we would have seen a little bit more from them maybe. So I'm not sure what happened during the picking stage, but Fnatic off to a good start here in the group.
Yeah, very convincing start. It was just really impressive play. You have everybody around here. Greycorn in the background. We're following Flusher right now. He's going to track down 3D Max at some point. There we are. So, still a very well-fought battle there. 3D Max did give it their all. That's the thing. It just came down to who was landing the shots in the end. And when JW starts to play like he did at the beginning of that half, Flusher landing just 6 shots left and right. Fnatic are really like the full package right now. They've got a sick caller in Pronax, but they've also got so much sheer raw talent on the team. Aim talent that are just able to get through these situations and make impossible situations possible. Like JW consistently wins situations with his AWP, well, the whirlwind, right? The AWP CZ combo just allows him to walk out of situations he should never be able to. And Flusher as well, Olafmeister, I mean, everybody on that team is so capable.
It's really scary. It definitely is. We'll have to see how they do later on, if they're going to be playing either Dignitas or Copenhagen Wolves.
Yeah.
We don't actually know if the Danish people have made it onto the site.
I saw Pimp. So Pimp was one of the Danish players who was delayed in his travel. Apparently, a couple of flights got delayed, so that's why there was a bit of a mix-up with the matches. But Pimp is here, so I saw him in the background. Now I'm wondering if the Dignitas players managed to make it. I didn't know who was missing from Dignitas.
I don't know. We'll figure it out, guys. We'll go to a break, and then we'll be back, and we'll have an update for you on the Danish situation. So stay with us, and we'll be right back.